Hello, this is Karen and I want to welcome you to our Dynamic Trios video over linear regression using SPSS.
Today the Dynamic Trio is going to tell you about linear functions that are a special type of algebraic functions that has a relationship with two distinct variables.
These two variables are the independent variable, x, and the dependent variable, y. To be a function, each x must map to only one y, according to Dr. Dog.
Linear functions include the regular properties of all functions and add signs special characteristics. To be a function, each x must map to only one y.
Another way of saying this is that each x value can only go to one location at a time.
Remember, linear regression is a prediction model in which one variable is used to predict a second variable. If the variables are highly correlated, the linear model is strong.
If the variables are poorly coordinated, according to Dr. Dog, then the linear model is weak.
Linear regression is used to create a line of best fit. Dr. Dog states that this line minimizes the distance between the linear model and each of the data points.
The line of best fit is the linear function which best fits a given set of data points.
The best fit line minimizes the distance of the linear regression model to each of the indicated points, which Dr. Dog talked about in his lecture.
According to Dr. Dog, the line of best fit is a fairly simple concept, as if you develop a linear model to match a set of data, you want the linear model which best fits the data.
The linear model can then fairly and accurately predict a y value for a given value of x.
When our dynamic trio used the data for our group project using SPSS, our results showed the percentage of part-time retention was a weak Pearson R. Also, the percentage of student to faculty showed a strong Pearson R. Using the formula of y equals x plus b, our results showed y equals 0.683 x plus 30.39 to the linear regression model.
The IPEDS data variables we used were public, 2-year, degree-granting community colleges in Texas in 2011. And the dependent variable was part-time retention rate, and the independent variable was student-to-faculty ratio.
Well, we have learned about using SPSS for computing linear regression and why we want to use the best fit line to determine if our data has a weak or strong correlation.